Hey guys, welcome back to another video. I am the Gaffinated Magician, back with another routine. Now, one of the reasons why I prefer doing close-up magic that I love about it the most is, as opposed to stage magic, which is more heavily relied on mirrors and special designed boxes and props, close-up is more about sleight of hand and manipulation. And one of the things that you can manipulate that's very fun to manipulate is anything made out of rubber or latex or whatever. For example, a balloon, okay? So look, I can take this balloon, and if I take the neck of the balloon and I rip it off just like that, I can create the illusion by taking the neck and putting it back onto and reattaching it to the balloon, just like so. Of course, this is just an illusion. I can create that illusion both also by inflating it. For example, if I just stretch this out and I blow it up, watch. And just kind of push it, pull it right off the, like that. I can pull it right off the balloon, and then I can reattach it, just like so. As a matter of fact, that really is fixed. So, the question is it illusion or reality? But really, everybody knows it's just manipulation. Magic isn't real. But it looks so real, and that's what I love about it. For example, like I said, all rubber is a thing that's fun to manipulate. Like a rubber band, for example. I can take a rubber band and make it go right through my fist, my fingers, just like so. Or my fingers this way. Watch. Look, just like that. That goes right through my finger. Or if I want to bring another rubber band into the mix, you're probably familiar with handcuffs. Well, with Filipino handcuffs, all you need is a Filipino and two rubber bands, and you put their handcuffs together like this. You link the rubber bands and put their hands together. We don't know how to get out of them. It doesn't go out this way, it doesn't go out this way. Of course, if you're a magician, we can kind of figure out the secret and make them go right through each other. Of course, that's the hard way. Unless you have years of practice. Otherwise, we're screwed. No. But yeah, and you can use other objects and combine them to create even a cooler illusion. For example, a deck of cards and a balloon. I can take the balloon, blow it up, and with enough pressure, I can push the balloon and the deck inside of the balloon, just like that. Went right inside of the balloon, and you can actually rip it right out. That's the only way to do it, to get it out, is to rip it open just like so, and you can see it's in there, and pull it right out. And since the balloon's broke, let me show you something with the deck and the rubber band. I'll just use one. If I take a card, just at random, and as you can see, you have a free selection of 52 cards, but we'll just take a card at random. For example, from the middle, we'll take the five of spades, and we'll just put that back in the spread. Now, if we take the three of spades here and isolate the deck with the rubber band, so there's no way I can manipulate the cards, even with that impossible condition, I can take the three, and with just a toss, I can cause the three, third time's a charm, to change into the selection that was in the middle of the deck you just saw a minute ago. Now, I can do it that way, or to make it even more impossible, I can take the card, place it in the middle, and I'll leave it sticking out for a second here up until after I put the rubber band around it, and now I'll put it in on the table. Now look, that looks like an impossible condition because my hands, for the most part, didn't hardly touch the deck. But even on those, under those impossible conditions, the card, just as a snap, rises to the very tippy top of the deck. And that is my cardboard and rubber routine. Hope you enjoyed. Stay happy, stay healthy, and I had too much caffeine today, but, well, I have my soda over there. Hold on. It's not coffee, but it'll do. There's caffeine and Pepsi. Stay caffeinated. Peace.